Welcome to today's Judicial topic, 21 positive and negative effects of practicing self-honesty, plus 19 benefits of being honest with yourself, plus 12 clarifications on what being honest truly means, and 30 ways to practice self-honesty, making it a natural part of your life and existence. For real value addition to this topic, please focus only on the content. Kindly ignore my lacunas in pronunciation, tone, expression, accent, grammar, my looks, and even these videos' background. If you need help on any specific topic or need coaching, mentoring, counseling to overcome the issues, the challenges, the problems you're facing in your personal, professional, business part of life, along with the relationship issues, kindly email me on the IDs given in either of my two websites. Please like the videos which adds value to you. Kindly subscribe and share this message about coaching session and the videos with your near and dear ones. Now, coming back to our topic. Acquire massive advantages by being honest with yourself. We should feel truly lucky and blessed if we have someone who is our most sincere well-wisher and kicks our ass regularly to make us see the real us. You can be honest with the world, but as long as you're not honest with yourself, it has no significant value. Now, there are 21 facts to illustrate both positive and negative, the effect of your life, effect in your life when you are practicing self-honesty. First, once we make being honest with ourselves a totally non-negotiable and part of our nature, we don't have any need to fake anything. And as a result thereof, we will have courage to share and open up with ourselves as well as with others without faking anything and have a very, very less degree of stress. When we practice self-honesty, all those people who are in our closest relationship circle would know where they stand with us. Trust and respect will define most of our important relationships. Communication, sharing, being vulnerable, open, and honesty is the first step and the trigger to start finding solutions. Having said these, you will also have to accept the fact that not everyone will feel comfortable with you and accept you. Especially when you are assertively claiming your rights and expressing your disagreements with the opinion of others and firmly standing on the ground, fighting for your beliefs, values, and what is right. It is all right to lose these relationships if they are external ones, as in any case, they don't add any value to you. If being your true self makes them feel uncomfortable and bad. Because your intention is always to clarify and not to hurt and make others feel bad. We must create a healthy balance to be sensitive and empathic to others' feelings. This can happen when our focus is only going for continuous self-development, self-growth and self-improvement. By working on our issues. This happens when we sincerely explore, learn, identify, know, and accept who we are and apologize when we goof up. Identify all the people who pull you down and the toxic ones and get them out of your life. When you can pay full attention to nurture all those people who deserve your time and energy as well as honesty. Even among these people, not everyone will appreciate your honesty. But you will have meaningful and sincere relationships in most areas of your life. Being honest with those who hurt you is mandatory. If you say nothing and shut it off, there is a danger you will carry the bitterness around with you and will poison all your other relationships, especially your closest ones. We need to let go of suppressing our negativities to simmer inside with impotent rage. Because it is the most destructive for you and all those who love you and whom you love and care for. Self-honesty is hard because looking at ourselves objectively could be very painful, shameful, and embarrassing. Once we are comfortable being ourselves, the next stage is to change our ways and life and situation that are not working anymore for us. During this process of metamorphosis, we may experience cognitive dissonance, which could be defined as severe emotional and mental fears which stresses us to a very high degree. We may have many hidden ghosts, that is mistakes, failures, regrets and embarrassing truths. We need inner healing and will happen only by bringing the skeletons out of the cupboard. We have to pay good attention and take extreme care to avoid deceiving ourselves, which takes place by consciously distorting and tinting our perception to hide facing reality. Then we use justification, blames and excuses to make us feel good. Now, there are 19 benefits of being honest with yourself. First, you will be proud of who you are when you accept yourself as you are by looking at both weaknesses and strengths objectively and with full honesty. You will experience a sense of liberation and freedom. Your life will be filled with much less fears and anxiety. What others think of you won't bother you at all. Your complete bouquet of self-worth, self-value, self-pride, self-love, self-esteem, self-confidence will get a tremendous boost. Self-honesty will make your close relationships healthier and meaningful. Your life will feel more beautiful and blissful. Because you're yourself and you know what you want, your passion to excel will increase exponentially. You will become respectable when you practice self-honesty, as you can never be honest with others if you're not honest with yourself. Telling the truth when tempted to lie helps improve our mental, emotional and physical health. Honesty is one of the key components to character and is generally the most admired qualities of all successful, happy people. We become more emotionally intelligent and more emotionally mature with very high degree of integrity. Honesty helps us find the answers we have been searching for. Honesty is crucial to a healthy relationship with ourselves and others. It can help us resolve long-standing issues and find forgiveness and deepen our relationship with the people who are around us. Self-honesty. Self-honesty has direct impact on our energy level, to less fatigue, to less depression, to less stress, and to less anxiety. Honest people can relax better and easily, naturally. Feel better because we practice assertive. Less occasions of being and feeling overwhelmed. By being direct and straightforward, we don't suffer from guilt pangs and regrets. In short term, knowing about our lacunas may make few of us flinch with pain. But in long term, this actually may start releasing endorphins by making us emotionally healthier. Now, 12 clarifications on what is being honest truly means. There are two possible ways not to tell the truth: by not providing the information that you have and by giving false information. Excessive sharing of personal information with everyone is unhealthy and is not about making us more honest. We don't have to explain and tell everyone everything. Context is the baseline. We need to analyze whether people need the information that we have and whether it will add positive value to us and to them. We don't have to share those things that someone has confided in you and asked you not to share. Sometimes it is better not to say something if it has got no value for anyone. We also need to be able to remain silent if the information will create chaos, problems, and stress. We have to actually decide if it is right to provide false information or lie on case-to-case basis based on our values and its value addition factors. Avoiding hurting others takes precedence over truthfulness. Truthfulness and tact must go hand in hand. There certainly will be few circumstances in which lying may be necessary. Again, it has to be purely on merit and impact. We have to find the balance, neither overplaying nor underplaying either our virtues or our weaknesses. The opposite of honesty is deception or lying. Lying to yourself is the worst thing you can do to yourself. Now, there are 30 ways we can practice self-honesty and make it a natural part of your life and existence. First, create your me time and your own sanctum sanctorium to relax, introspect and meditate, so that slowly you're able to hear your inner voice. Have a support system, as practicing self-honesty is very, very tough, and we need to have people whom we trust and who have our best interests at heart, especially for painfully reality check. all the areas of life where we have very high levels of dissatisfaction, we need to reassess with brutal honesty on what are not working and what we need to change and whether we should go for a complete fresh start. Understand that no matter how much we are able to cover it up for the world, we will always be what we are at the core. We can change our life dramatically only by practicing the following five things: creating and having the desire to change ourselves, the courage to take tough decisions, taking actions whenever is needed, using discipline to practice the new habits and behaviors we need to inculcate for the changes that we want and chosen, the determination to persist until we get the results that we desire. Sixth, the choices are only ours to make, but we need to start somewhere. So start small, but start. We need to pick one area of our life that needs urgent improvement. Divide the big changes into small incremental improvement milestones. Create timeline and schedule small action steps into everyday life. Trying too much to do at one time can backfire and may become so overwhelming that may make us give up totally and also may burn us out. Therefore, commit to taking actions consistently by giving your 100% every time. We have to become flexible to pivot when things don't work, because our failure to adapt, try new things, experiment with new methods, techniques, people and choices will only stop us from achieving what we can. It is especially important because things which work today might not work tomorrow. We have to be totally clear in what we want and why we want. Therefore, do why exercises till you get the answers, which is very motivating and inspiring. Instead of just having a goal of losing fat, to look better, to feel good about yourself, to be more assertive and confident, to get what you want out of life. Explore and identify what are things within you which are holding you back. Try to see things from the other person's point of view. Visualize yourself in the future while you are meditating. Create the pictures with qualities and type of life. Admit it when you make mistakes. Pay attention to your feelings. Stop overanalyzing and overthinking. Get outside perspective. Accept what you don't know, and it is important to go and learn. Detecting your self-deception. Become aware. Pay attention to your thought patterns to know when you're lying to yourself. Notice your emotions. When we react emotionally to something or someone, it is because we are being reminded of something painful, raw, or unresolved in our lives. These will give us most valuable clues for finding our true self in these areas. Identify when you struggle most to admit the truth, the situation and people both. Notice your thoughts. If you notice your thinking is extreme or irrational, challenge your assumption. Notice your behavior. If you feel it is not what you are, ask yourself why you are behaving like this. What you do not want to admit to yourself. Be dependable. Follow through on your commitments. Don't commit to anything that you cannot honor. Be honest to yourself also means knowing when to avoid conflict, when to address conflict, and when to create conflict. Use honesty to encourage, not criticize. Use your